COVID-19 has put a stop to many activities worldwide, both commercial and leisure activities alike. St. Lucia Carnival, according to well-known attorney at law and staunch reveler Thaddeus Antoine, may have been one of the pandemic's biggest victims.
COVID is a strange thing. St. Lucia's Carnival has been growing consistently every year. And we no doubt believe that this year will be an epic year. Perhaps, well, I would say the largest year in the modern carnival of St. Lucia. I mean, most of events were already pretty much sold out from far. The diaspora and visitors from around the world were looking forward to coming to St. Lucia. A lot of them for the first time. Because what has really changed the dynamics in our carnival, just not just the costumes, but the music and the fets. So you have the Dennery segment music, which is a different type of genre. So it's caused people some level of excitement and they'll say, well, what is the music about? It's different. And it was several years ago when we used to bring on Marshall. Marshall says to me, boy, is that Dennery segmenting? That will change St. Lucia. And he was saying to me that he wants to come back to St. Lucia to go and sit by the fishermen, by the farmers, to get to understand them, because he believed that's where the music is coming from. It's very localized. You see, that will make the difference in the music. And so said, so done. So this year, so COVID-19 has changed a lot for us. A lot for the revelers, a lot for the music fraternity, and a lot for the art form on the whole. But, you know, things happen, we are woke with it.
According to Antoine, adhering to health and safety protocols instituted by the CMO and the health department, and preventing the spread of the virus has to be everybody's focus now. The sooner it is brought under control, the sooner life can get back to normal, and that includes all things carnival.
I'm happy to see that protocols have been worked on to see what do we do as we go forward. So for the moment, the protocols allow up to 200 people for an event. These are the things you have to do to allow for proper contact tracing. We will do those things. We'll go through and test it as we go along to see what the capacity is and can we manage with it and to go forward. Because as people say, we had to live with COVID for some time. We had to find a way to mitigate it and get more discipline in dealing with it. But we had to do it. Next year is coming and I'm looking forward to having a great carnival next year. It will happen in one way or the other. It will happen. Carnival is carnival, you know. The people who love it and the people who hate it. Those who hate it really hate it. Those who love it, boy, they love it with a passion. So all you need to hear is two sticks knocking together on a bottle or something like that, and they're good. So for a lot of revelers, it's really, as we say in our local parlance, it's a real go-well. It's a real, real, real go-well for us and stuff like that. So we try to do things. And the thing about it, with social media is a bit wicked, you know, because social media reminds you of those photos you've taken a few years ago about events, about on the road, and it comes up in your feed. And you say, boy, boy. and we get out a lot of that, they say, a lot of that. So every day I get one or two photos coming through my feed of photos I took 2 years, 3 years, even last year. So that's coming through. So it's hard.
According to Prime Minister Alan Chastney, there is a possibility that St. Lucia Carnival could be held in October. Antoine and other carnival lovers like him are optimistic that it will happen. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.